now it's the time to celebrate how successfully we have completed our 1 week online faculty development program on exploring entrepreneurship and startup opportunities through tourism and hospitality business. Before starting this valedictory function, I would like to invite our honorable pro vice chancellor, Mizoram University, Professor Jagdish Kumar Patnaik sir. Sir, you are cordially invited to our program, sir. Namaste, sir. In capacity of the coordinator for this 1 week online faculty development program sponsored by AICTE Hotel, I am going to present the summary report of this faculty development program in front of you, sir. The Department of Tourism and Hospitality Management, Mizoram University, organized a 1 week online faculty development program on exploring entrepreneurship and startup opportunities through tourism and hospitality business from 14 to 18 September 2020, sponsored by AICTE Training and Learning Portal. A specific theme was there. The themes are concept of entrepreneurship, socio-economic and environmental impact of entrepreneurship in tourism and hospitality business, tourism and hospitality industry, tourism and hospitality business entrepreneurship, startup loans and financial assistance, role of government, state and central in stimulating entrepreneurship. There were altogether 120 participants from different states and union territories of India. The participants comprised mainly faculty members, research scholars and PG students with tourism and hospitality and business management background. The program was constituted of 14 sessions, with each session being presided over by the same number of distinguished resource persons from different institutions of national report. The online inaugural ceremony of faculty development program was attended by Honorable Vice Chancellor of Mizoram University, Professor K.R.S. Sambasiva Rao sir, Reverend Dean of School of Management, Economics and Information Science, Professor R.K. Nurthinkuma, other senior professors, and Professor Sitikantha Misra, Governing Member, IITTM, Government of India. In his welcome speech, Dr. Himanshu Bhushan Rao, myself, program coordinator, Hotel FDP, DTHM, Mizoram University, highlighted the importance of the event and noted that a changing paradigm in combination with new investment potential indicates the importance of entrepreneurship is at the forefront of the growing tourism and hospitality industry. He further added that the current landscape of the Indian tourism and hospitality industry presents a unique opportunity for novel business ideas to grow and succeed. While addressing the participants, Professor R.K. Nurthinkuma stressed upon entrepreneurship and startup ventures in the tourism and hospitality sector by asserting that this sector is still largely an unexplored area. Therefore, an exploration of this area can be substantial significance in addressing various social ills and complex challenges that are prevalent in modern society. The appropriate development of the tourism and hospitality business will improve the welfare of local communities surrounding or within the area of tourism destination. The development will also ensure economic and social sustainability. At the end, Dr. Rajdeep Dev, Assistant Professor, Department of Tourism and Hospitality Management, Mizoram University, thanked all the distinguished dignitaries for their kind presence during the opening ceremony, which was immediately followed by the first technical session. The first session was on role of human values and ethics in entrepreneurship in Indian context. The resource person was Professor Sitikantha Misra, Governing Member, IITTM, Government of India. The speaker emphasized on the significance of value system, ethical practices, and socio-cultural structure in business. Further, he asserted that in no circumstances these values should be undermined, for instance, in case of COVID-19 pandemic. Session two was need of entrepreneurship and actors of building entrepreneurs in tourism and hospitality. Resource person was Professor N.B.R. Jyoti Kumar, Department of Commerce, Mizoram University. The speaker delineated about the importance of fostering enabling entrepreneurial ecosystem to support the grooming of budding entrepreneurs in tourism and hospitality. He further highlighted the key features of entrepreneurs, which include business opportunity recognition, innovation, risk taking, idea creation, creativity, achievement orientation, and resourcefulness. Session third was ideation in tourism and hospitality business. Resource person was Professor N.M. Panda, Department of Commerce, Northeastern Hill University, Shillong. The speaker elaborated on the various dimensions of innovation and on how to channelize this innovation in achieving entrepreneurship goals. He further stressed upon the need of cultivation of new ideas among the budding entrepreneurs. He argued that in the currently challenging business environment, innovative ideas from the cardinal points in achieving success than only big investments. Fourth session was on infrastructure and investments in tourism and hospitality sector of India. Resource person was Professor Bhartindu Singh, Department of Commerce, Mizoram University. The speaker focused on the role of infrastructural development in the growth of tourism and hospitality industry. While speaking on the topic, he emphasized on how new infrastructural development are transforming the landscape of community development at the tourism destinations and leading to the achievement of sustainable development goals of the United Nations. Session fifth was role of ICT in tourism and hospitality business in India. Resource person was Professor L.S. Sharma, Department of Management, Mizoram University. The speaker at the very outset explained the various aspects of ICT tools. He brought forth the role of ICT in changing the way the business used to be done before. He also emphasized that post-COVID-19 situation will enhance the use of information communication technology in a bigger way. In a way, he advocated the more and more use of technology by the entrepreneurs. Session six was trends and issues in the tourism and hospitality industry. Resource person was Professor Vibraj Bhushan Parida, Department of Tourism Management, the University of Burdwan, West Bengal. The speaker highlighted the novel trends surfacing in the tourism and hospitality industry. Also, he spoken at length about various emerging trends in tourism and hospitality, namely nature-based tourism, community-based tourism, wellness tourism, responsible tourism, and various sustainable types of tourism. These fields offer immense opportunities for the further entrepreneurs, especially in the context of developing destinations. Seventh session was on origin and development of tourism entrepreneurship in India. Resource person was Professor Nimit Ranjan Chaudhary, Department of Tourism and Hospitality Management, Jamia Millia Islamia. The speaker, in his address to the participants, focused on the history of entrepreneurship and how this field transformed into an area of high interest for academics, industry practitioners, and others. He emphasized the role of entrepreneurs in building self-reliant India or Atmanirbhar Bharat. Session 8 was financial support ecosystem for startups in India. Resource person was Professor Sanjeev Kumar Jena, Department of Commerce, Rajiv Gandhi University, Arunachal Pradesh. Individuals who dream to become entrepreneurs are usually considered by the lack of resources, mainly financial. The speaker discussed in details the various schemes floated by the government to stimulate entrepreneurship. He also asserted many of the top corporates are always ready to support the promising ideas of the young entrepreneurs. Session 9 was on entrepreneurship and startups in tourism and hospitality sector, status, opportunities, and challenges. Resource person was Professor S.K. Gupta, Center for Mountain Tourism and Hospitality Studies, HNB Garhwal University. The speaker analyzed the reasons for failure as well success of startups in tourism and hospitality business. He explained this with the help of real life case studies. He also said that majority of startups fail in the initial stages because of lack of entrepreneurial qualities. So it is highly important to imbibe those crucial qualities among the entrepreneurs. Session 10, myths about entrepreneurship and realities. Resource person was Professor Anjaneya Swami, Central University of Andhra Pradesh. The speaker tried to bust the myths that are associated with entrepreneurship. He firmly asserted that money is not the only critical criteria for becoming an entrepreneur. He further highlighted some of the prevalent myths with this phenomenon, particularly entrepreneurs are born, not made. entrepreneurs are gamblers, motivated primarily by money, entrepreneurs should be young, etc. Session 11 was role of social entrepreneurship in tourism and hospitality business. Resource person was Professor Sudhir Andrew, distinguished speaker and author. The speaker emphasized the role of social entrepreneurship in raising funds of conducting tourism business activities that inspire and encourage local communities to participate to carry out business activities. Further, he stressed upon the relevance of social entrepreneurship in the context of tourism, dealing with entrepreneurship, sustainability, social entrepreneurship, and destination development. Session 12 was further paradigms of sustainable tourism and hospitality business in India. Resource person was Professor Sampath Kumar Swain, Department of Tourism Studies, Pondicherry University. The speaker focused on a wide-ranging vision of multitude of trends in the global travel and tourism industry today and in the future. He further asserted that the evolution and application of digital technologies are profoundly changing the way people live, work, travel, and do business. And in the process, they are transforming and reshaping tourism. Session 13 was on thrust areas of entrepreneurship in hospitality business. Resource person was Professor Asim Ranjan Parida, distinguished speaker and entrepreneur from Dubai. The speaker emphasized on cataloging information and sharing knowledge. He also stressed upon seamless technology to attract, serve, and retain customers. Further, he asserted that competition is between the technologies today, and firms having better technology will surely have a competitive advantage over the other players in the market. The last session was on funding agencies for tourism and hospitality business ventures in India. Resource person was a profound speaker, Professor Tapan Kumar Panda, Director, NMIMS Hyderabad, the former director of IIM Indore. The speaker has thrown light on the various sources of funding available for the entrepreneurial ventures and startups. He stressed upon two crucial concepts to be discussed in tourism field, namely economies of scale and economies of scope. During the discussions, participants penetrated into different emerging areas of research interest in the field tourism and hospitality, which may be taken into consideration while organizing faculty development program, workshops, seminars in future. Thank you all. Now it's my honor to invite our honorable Vice Chancellor, Pro Vice Chancellor, Mizoram University, Professor Jagdish Kumar Patnaik. Sir, kindly give you a few words, few suggestions towards our program. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Professor Raut. First of all, let me congratulate you for having successfully completed this 1 week, 1 week or 2 week long? Is it 2 week long?
1 week, sir. One week long,
this FDP, Faculty Development Program, under the aegis of this Atal thing. I also congratulate the participants. I'm really happy that there are 120 participants taking part in this week-long program, and all the participants might have gained a lot. Basically, I'm a layman with regard to whether entrepreneurship or startup or the tourism and hospitality management, whatever. Being a layman, whatever little bit impressions that I have, I want to share with you for within a couple of minutes. To my mind, tourism happens to be the most potential arena where we can have substantial contribution to our economy, to our GDP. Whatever little bit of knowledge I have got, the data that I have with me, that tourism constitutes around 9% of our GDP. Interestingly, I don't know whether any one of the participants did speak to you about the potential of medical tourism. The potential of medical tourism for India is very large. Having said that, India was actually doing well in the last couple of years in terms of, you know, getting good number of tourists from across. The tourism industry is not only confined to the domestic market, it is also relevant for the international market. Basically, when we get international tourists, it does contribute to our economy. Now, over the years, I think Professor Himanshu will bear with me that tourism has become the chief contributor for the sustainable development impacts. And in India, there is a kind of sustainable tourism which creates jobs, promotes local culture, promotes local products. Tourism also encourages religious tourism. You have got ecotourism. Why I tell these things? Because I come from a place to which, of course, the honorable coordinator also does belong, Odisha. Odisha has a vast potential of the tourist industry, but we are not able to sustain it, have a sustainable kind of development, tourism development, despite the efforts of the government. To what extent the government has been active? Actually, it's for Dr. Raut to speak about, because I'm not an expert in the field. But we can, in the state of Odisha, for example, we could do much more. Kerala is the number one state in terms of revenue generation from the tourist industry, tourism industry. Having a small state, but it is having the number one position. Other states, bigger states are there. But compared to that, Kerala has been doing wonderful. But here I would like to bring in one important element. How in the recent days and weeks and months, the entire economy is disrupted. The COVID-19 pandemic has really disrupted the entire tourism industry. It has come to a standstill. There is a total collapse of the tourist industry. I do not know how soon and how good we could recover from this pandemic disruption. Why I brought this pandemic thing is because the pandemic has not only destroyed the tourist industry, it has impacted substantially on our economy. Not only our economy, it has impacted the entire global economy. And the worst sufferers are the people who are serving the tourist industry. There is total loss of jobs. I do not know whether it was 90% or 95% of the people who are on the roads now without having jobs, particularly pertaining to the tourist industry. The hotels are shut down. The transport sector is shut down. Other hospitality sectors, aspects of this tourism industry, are also facing very tough time. And here is the challenge. In a few months' time, that is maybe 4 months or maximum 6 months' time, we have to recoil back. Because once the vaccine is ready, things will run quick and fast. And how our entrepreneurs and how our these venture capitalists helping in the startups to recoup the tourist industry, the tourism industry. That is a big challenge. Because the biggest challenge that we are facing is the total collapse. It is reduced to nullity. You may think that I'm exaggerating the situation, but this is the fact of the matter. And how we can get back on the track. Getting back on the track is not very important. You will get back once the transport industry is restored, whether air transport or the road transport or even water transport. Because in terms of air infrastructure, we are also very good compared to other developing countries. India, being a developing country, is in a position to generate revenue. But having said that, let me tell you, we are not in a position to generate as much revenue as a small country like United Arab Emirates. Maybe I can give you a dated data. In a year, they could generate $24 billion from revenue from tourist industry. Whereas we got only $11 billion with regard to, I'm talking about the inflow of tourists in terms of air traffic. Now, all these things that you have been talked today, this week, have to be revived, put in place, proper place, following the post-COVID scenario. The post-COVID scenario has made us to rethink, refashion ourselves to cope up with the hardship. And I'm sure in a 6 months' time, already things are now, unlock four is there in India. Things are moving, but not so fast. Things are not moving so fast. Train services are not restored fully. Not at all. Actually, there are only special trains running. Air services are also not restored fully. Once there will be total wholesale restoration of these things, we will be in a position to come to the track. I don't say that we'll get back to our original position in a span of a month or two. It's not that easy. Here, another interesting thing I want to just share with you is that our tourist industry is focused in a wayward fashion. They may have their own strategies, I don't know. And our tourist entrepreneurs, they are focused on a very narrow area. It has to be a wider and comprehensive focus in terms of their strategies in, you know, expanding the tourist industry. And that actually needs serious thinking. Some people like Dr. Himanshu and others who can contribute in a substantial measure. And I also want that you participants who have gained some knowledge can contribute in terms of writings at least. Because basically I think you are all teachers and you don't get into the tourist industry directly, but you can contribute by writing articles, providing innovative strategies to the tourist industry so that it would get back to normal and pick up its rhythm. It's not an easy job. It's going to be a very tough job for us, I know. Not only for us, for Indians, I'm talking about others. Other countries also, developing countries. Developed countries like the United States is also scratching the floor. Except few countries like China and others. But the Chinese economy is also facing tough time. not from the tourist point of view, from other point of view also. Indian diaspora is there. If we can focus, to give an example for you, for your a food for thought. All across the globe, Indian diaspora is there. And there is no movement of any Indian diaspora to come back to India in the last 6 months. And once the things open up, things get loosened up after the vaccine invention, which I hope within 6 months time it is going to come, we can tap the vast diaspora who are yearning to come back to India to see, to visit their places, their people. If we just focus on like on this diaspora, for example, or if we focus on religious tourism, my state Odisha is religiously very rich, or other states, even Uttar Pradesh or Tamil Nadu, all our states, we have got this religious tourism which we are not able to tap to the extent desired. And once the pandemic is over, we can generate interest among it is the people of the diaspora to take a chance and have this kind of tourism. So you can go on imagining, you can go on thinking. Just I'm a layman, I'm just thinking and thinking. I started thinking after Dr. Himanshu called me up. Sir, there is a program. I forgot totally. Actually, I didn't remember that I was having this program to speak to. What I mean to say is, if you make serious thinking and serious academic thinking, you can contribute for the enrichment of the tourism industry in India. Whatever little exposure that you have to this week through the lectures from the resource persons, the distinguished resource persons, and I am happy to hear that Raut was able to tap people from different parts of the country to speak to you. And I would say that this group of 120 participants is very fortunate. Pandemic is a challenge. It has really robbed us of many things. But I tell you, this pandemic has given us a new opportunity, like this new normal, when we have this online interaction. And this is going to be part and parcel of our future, this online interaction, and through which we can gain lot of knowledge, lot of understanding about various issues. So you participants are very fortunate to have got the exposure to the resource persons from all across the country. And I thank my friend and my younger brother, Dr. Himanshu Raut, that he would be able to organize such a wonderful program, a week-long program. It is not a matter of joke, I know, because to tap these resource persons is a very tough thing. And also equally to manage the technical aspect, the internet, this, that, and Zoom is good, of course. So far my experience, for me, Zoom is better than other. I'm not, marketing for Zoom, but then I tell you, there are many difficult things that he has to grapple with in conducting this 1 week program. I really appreciate the efforts by Dr. Raut and his team for organizing this wonderful week-long program. And I also thank personally for inviting me to speak something maybe irrelevant, but to as a job of a pro VC and some kind of ceremonial thing. I thank Dr. Raut for having invited me, and I thank all of you, the participants, for having listened to me patiently. Thank you very much.
Sir, thank you, sir. Now I will request to Dr. Rajdeep Dev to give a vote of thanks.
Thank you very much, sir. Before I propose a vote of thanks, just a small announcement. Those participants who have attended the program from the very first day till today, I know you have certain doubts about certificates and attendance. Just to tell you that after this session, AICT will send you a form, online form, which you have to fill. And this, but after you fill it up, the AICT will process for your final certificates. So from today, I mean from now, AICT will take care of these certificates and all those feedback form. In case if you receive any communication from AICT office, we'll definitely get back to you. If any kind of clarifications or any kind of official notifications, we'll definitely let you know. So with this, let me just propose a vote of thanks. At the very outset, I would like to wish everyone a very good evening, especially to our Honorable Pro Vice Chancellor Sir, Professor J.K. Patnaik, and all the dear participants. So we have reached the concluding part of this 1 week online OTL FDP with this particular session. So I, Dr. Rajdeep Dev, Assistant Professor, Department of Tourism and Hospitality Management, Mizoram University, take this opportunity to deliver a vote of thanks at the valedictory session of this online FDP on behalf of the department. At the very outset, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to our Honorable Vice Chancellor, to our Pro Vice Chancellor, Sir, Professor J.K. Patnaik, for accepting our request and taking time out of his busy schedule to attend the valedictory session. Further, we extend our sincere gratitude to our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Sir, Professor K.R.S. Sambasiva Rao, for encouraging us to conduct an FDP like this. Sir, we're really thankful to you. We're really thankful to you, sir, for your kind support, suggestions, and guidance as and when required. We also express our acknowledgement to AICT particularly the ATAL, for sanctioning the fund to organize this online FDP. We also express our sincere thanks and appreciation and acknowledgement to all our 14 distinguished resource persons for giving their consent to be a part of this online FDP and sharing their valuable inputs. Sir, this program would have been incomplete without your valuable inputs and support. We are really thankful to you, and we also hope that in future as well, all of you will extend your kind guidance and cooperation to us for striving higher goals. Thank you very much, sir. We were highly enriched with your vast knowledge and experience. Also, we convey our sincere thanks to Professor L.S. Sharma and Dr. Amit Kumar Singh, Department of Management, Mizoram University, for their continued guidance and support. We thank Public Relations Officer and the staff of ICT Center of Mizoram University. And here I would like to mention one particular name. His name is Mr. Tara Chauhan. He has really helped us a lot with these technical aspects. So Tara, we are really thankful to you. We sincerely thank all the participants because they are one of the most important pillars of this particular FDP. So it's our duty, and we feel that because of them, this online FDP has become successful. So we sincerely thank all the 120 participants for making all the sessions very vibrant and also penetrating into different emerging areas of research interest in the field of tourism and hospitality. We hope that we'll conduct this kind of seminars in the future as well, and we welcome you, and we hope that all of you will join in the future as well. However, this vote of thanks will remain incomplete if I do not mention two important names. First name is Dr. Himanshu Bhushan Rao, Head and Associate Professor, Department of Tourism and Hospitality Management, Mizoram University, who is also the coordinator of ATAL FDP and Dr. Pankaj Kumar, Assistant Professor, Department of Tourism and Hospitality Management, Mizoram University. Honestly speaking, it was due to their untiring efforts, their conceptualizations, and the way they have looked into each and every aspect of the program that we could successfully complete this online FDP. So I once again thank everyone who directly or indirectly contributed to this FDP. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.